A charity boss who's black and was repeatedly asked where she came from at a Buckingham Palace reception says she felt abused by the encounter. Ngozi Fulani, who's British and a founder of Sister Space, which works to support abused women, likened the conversation with Lady Susan Hussey to an interrogation. Lady Susan, who's 83, is godmother to the Prince of Wales and has now resigned from the royal household. The palace has described her remarks as unacceptable and deeply regrettable. Here's our royal correspondent, Sarah Campbell.
Ngozi Fulani, standing next to the Queen Consort with her back to the camera, was at Buckingham Palace in her role as a prominent campaigner helping women and families affected by domestic abuse. Minutes after arriving, she was approached by a palace aide, Lady Susan Hussey.
When the lady first approached me, one of the first things she did was to take my locks and move it out of the way. No conversation at first, and then she says, I just want to see your name back.
Ms. Fulani, a British national, then says she was repeatedly and aggressively questioned.
I'm from here, I was born here. Yeah, but where are you really from? I'm really from here. Yeah, but okay, so I can see that this is going to be a bit of a challenge. She said, what's your nationality? And I said, lady, I was born here, I'm British. I was thinking that would be the end of it. No.
Lady Susan Hussey, here in the blue, who was a lady-in-waiting to Queen Elizabeth for six decades, stepped aside from her honorary role yesterday. A palace statement said the individual concerned expressed her profound apologies for what happened.
Are you clear in your mind that what happened was a racist incident?
I'm very clear. Right. No matter how uncomfortable it is for other people to accept, I'm very clear that I experienced racism in an environment that I should have felt safe in, and we need to address that.
The row overshadowed the arrival in the United States of the Prince and Princess of Wales. The focus was supposed to be on environmental issues, but instead, before they landed, their spokesperson was compelled to make the royal couple's position clear that racism has no place in our society. Buckingham Palace said in a statement it had reached out to Ngozi Fulani. Today, she says she's still waiting for direct contact to be made.
Nobody's reached out to us directly from the palace. We would look forward to a conversation because this can't be, I'm sorry, and move on.
That was Sarah Campbell with that report. Well, our correspondent Nada Taufik is in Boston for us and has been following the royal tour there. Nada, I was actually at that reception at Buckingham Palace, and the focus was supposed to be around violence against women and the elimination of that. Clearly, this has overshadowed that event. And just give us a sense of what it's doing with the visit of Prince William and Kate.
Yeah, well, Yalda, I mean, obviously, this is an incredibly embarrassing start to what should have been really the biggest showcase event for William and Catherine, this Earthshot Prize that William started to try to bring light to climate change. Instead, they had to, as we heard there in that package, put out a statement immediately saying that racism has no place in society. Of course, they're trying to underline immediately how they feel about the incident, but also trying to get ahead of it so they can then focus on the task at hand here in Boston. Now, we have seen it be part of coverage here in the United States, along with the other events that they went to last night. So it certainly is factoring into minds here in the United States. Also, a reverend and community activist at City Hall yesterday urged the crowd to think about the long legacy of colonialism and racism. So clearly, they're possibly an uncomfortable uncomfortable moment for William and Catherine, but they are hoping that the work they do here in Boston speaks for itself. They say the Earthshot Prize, everything they're about, talking about climate change and social change, is all about inclusivity and diversity. So they are hoping that they can still try to recast the monarchy with this modern face. And in fact, today, besides going to a leading incubator for tech startups here in North America that has supported companies that are trying to drive innovation around climate change, they are also visiting a nonprofit called ROCA, which works with underserved communities. It fights against racism, and they had that planned on the schedule already as part of this drive to talk to communities directly, speaking to young men and young mothers about how society can work better to support underserved communities.
Great. Thank you very much for that update.